months ago I demonstrated a Raspberry Pi virtual reality headset. A few of you may remember that. Unfortunately, a few days later, it broke, so I had to order a new screen, and whilst it was coming, I decided to get involved with my project. So, I found there was no easy way to interact with the 3D environment, short of a keyboard. So I had a look at some solutions other people had come up with, and I narrowed it down into four categories. First of all, tracked controllers. It's a controller that the person holds and is tracked in 3D space. Untracked controllers, which are just controllers with buttons on. Restrained body tracking, which is where your body stays still while it's tracked. And unrestrained body tracking, where you can move anywhere and the computer tracks you. So I knew straight away I wouldn't be able to do full body tracking because of the cost, and I didn't want to look stupid in a green outfit. I didn't want to do untracked controllers because they're a bit boring, so that only left me with one possibility, tracked controllers. So I made this, the Raspberry Pi Virtual Glove. Based on an app-maker based control board, it uses 3D printed joint trackers to track the position of four potentiometers and relay this back to the Pi. The circuit board I designed myself and then got manufactured for quite a low cost. So what can it actually do? It can track the position of four fingers and relay this information back to the Pi. At the moment the connection is wired, but in the future I hope to make it Bluetooth. At the moment it can't track the position of your thumb, and at the moment it can't track the position of your hand in 3D space. I'm working on this and I hope to get it done by next month. So how much did this actually cost? Going through all the costings, it didn't actually cost that much, and in the end it came to a total just under £15. So this is a really low cost way of interacting with the virtual environment, exactly what I wanted. But then I realised quite a lot of people had done this before, so there are many other examples. And then I had an idea. What if you could interact with the virtual environment with your mind? Now before you dismiss this as crazy, let me show you this. If it works. It's an invention called the Nekomimi, and it was meant to be a video. So it's a pair of cat ears that responds to your brain activity. So for example, if you got interested by a donut, your ears would perk up. And then when you relax, they go back down. So I bought one of these off Amazon, and after a quick play around, it's not as bad as the other product though, a mind-controlled tail. So I bought one of these off Amazon and I took it apart. I found two boards, the servo controller board, but more importantly, a board called the TGAM1. This is the actual board that reads your mind, effectively. So I took a look at the data sheet and found that it communicated through serial. So I hooked up PowerGround and TX to a HC06 Bluetooth module, and it didn't work. Reading through the data sheet again, I found I had to solder some resistors in place to control the baud rate, and after that it worked. I was getting hex values back over Bluetooth. So I took the original headset, removed the ears, and then the important step, come up with a name. I decided to call it the MindWave, because that sounds pretty cool. But at the moment it was only four hex values coming in over Bluetooth. I needed some kind of software. So I put the Bluetooth dongle into my Raspberry Pi, jumped into Python, and created a Python module. So in the end, it only needs three lines to work. Firstly, import the module, then initialize the Bluetooth connection, and finally, read into three appropriately named variables all the values. So it returns the meditation, which is how relaxed you are, attention, which is how attentive you are, and then signal, which is just how good a connection it has. But all in all, that wasn't overly impressive. It's only three values. So I took some code originally by Trevor Appleton and made mind-controlled Pong. So using the attention value, I control the left paddle, and here's me playing it. So it's sped up because it's a bit boring in real time. Looking at it, I hit it 10 out of 25%, which is 40%. But if it had been random, I would have only hit it 20% of the time. This seems to show that I do at least have some control over it. So now I just had to implement it into virtual reality, and this is where the problems came in. So I was running two SD cards at the moment, one for virtual reality and one for my MindWave. The MindWave one had all Bluetooth software installed and my Python module. They were both running Raspbian, although my MindWave one was running Raspbian Wheezy and my virtual reality one was running Raspbian Jessie. Now, in theory, I could just move my Python module across and reinstall Bluetooth software, but unfortunately, Jessie doesn't yet have support for Bluetooth in Python. So, at the moment, I'm not really in virtual reality, but I hope to have that very soon, as soon as they support it. So, in conclusion, I now have two ways of feeding back into the Raspberry Pi inputs, which can then be hopefully transferred into the virtual world. For example, you could be able to pick things up, or maybe even have a Star Wars game where you can actually use the Force. Thank you for listening. Any questions?
Yes. Have you brought it with you?
Yes, it's over there at the back.
Can I have a go?
Yeah.
You just want to play with the ears, don't you? That's
Does the virtual reality interact with the gloves as well?
Yes, I've got that set up over there as well.
Have you tried using PIP for your Python modules rather than apt-get?
No, I haven't tried that.
Try using PIP, it's the way forward.
Right, I'll try that out.